Hi guys, got a bit of repair work to do here. Have some rather boisterous grandsons. My daughter's just left these chairs for me to have a look at. Now this one, taking the seat off, that's over there. This one used to be my mum and dad's. So it's probably 60 years old. So it's missing a screw there. That might just be a matter of tightening that up. Broken down there. I think we're going to have to just glue and then drill through and screw at the same time, just to stick that back together. It's been re-varnished once, and all that's come off it again. Used to have a red seat on it, which we recovered years ago. An old pair of denim jeans. Very similar to what I did with that thing not so long ago. And that's probably about the same age, that stool. And then these two chairs are looking a bit sorry. They're IKEA Stefan. Those clips there go into these holes here. But before we can do that, I'm going to have to put that in. Again, I'll glue it and screw it. She's not too worried about looks. She just likes something to sit on. Same with that one. Put that in, glue it. In fact, although it looks a bit bad, it's really not too bad. It's just those two. Put that in and glue it, put that in and glue it, clamp it up. Well, in fact, if I drill straight through and screw into it, I don't need clamps either. Put that back on. This one is similar. Broken there, broken there. But here, that doesn't look so good, does it? It might be alright if I just take it off, put glue into it, clamp it to hold it until it glue dries. It might be alright. It's not the ideal way of doing it. I could probably put a screw. I was going to say I could probably put a screw straight down that way, but because that screw is in the way, to go straight down there. We'll see. See what we can do. My wife's just been disinfecting these before we touch them, so we haven't touched the stuff that my other family was touching. Yeah. So I think these ones look fairly straightforward. Wood glue on them. Drill through, nice big screw, right the way through. Same problem, that screw's in the way, so I have to miss that screw. That screw. Gonna have to miss that when I screw top and bottom of it, I should think. Right, glue on there, glue on there. dirty great screw. Yeah. That looks all right. Just need to clean that out. Might undo that one because that looks like that could do with tightening up. That's a harder bit of wood. Must have been a knot. A bit blunt. Probably been using it for doing metal. Doesn't help, does it? Oh, another screw. Probably ought to put one in there anyway. It hasn't pulled right up yet. Thank you. Right, I think that's all we need to do to that one. Right. Done. Right, chair number two. I've taken the seat off it. So, that bit's straightforward. And just glue and screw. That one's okay, same thing, glue and screw. This is the bit that worries me. So that is broken. I don't know if I can squeeze some glue into the splits and then put a screw straight down from the top to try and stiffen it. It's this split here. Doesn't look very healthy. So squeeze some glue into the crack. Clamp it shut for now. And then, as I say, put a long screw down through there. I don't know if I've got any longer screws in this, because we've got to miss that hole that that screw goes through. Yeah, that's only just going to get into the top of it. I think that's what I'll do though. I'll squeeze glue into the cracks, clamp it shut for now, and then put a screw straight down through it. It's certainly going to be a weakness. Ideally, you'd actually replace the whole piece of wood. But my days of having a wood pile of useful bits of wood are long gone. I just have to try and work it in. A bit closer to that screw than I meant to. Let's try it at a bit of an angle.
Well, actually, that's not a bad thing, thinking about it. I can tip some glue in there, and then when we clamp it that way, see where all the glue is squeezing out down there. Still loose. Right, we'll come back to this, we'll let that glue dry. Thinking about it, I might as well put this screw back in again while it's clamped together. A screw in that direction as well. Right, I've given it a while to dry. It's probably not perfect. This really is not going to be a very strong joint here. Typical. I was hoping to leave that on there. Right, so glue, glue, screw, screw. Like a helicopter going over. Right, back to where we were. Sounds like another helicopter coming. Little break in continuity there when I stopped to film a passing helicopter. Right, so there we are, back together. Don't hold out a lot of hope for that particular leg though. In an ideal world, I'd have gone to my wood pile, pulled out a suitable piece of wood, and replaced it. But I don't have a wood pile anymore. Not that sort of wood pile anyway. So, that's number two chair fixed as far as we can go. Little bits go in those holes back there and then screw up into there. Expect now I need to tidy up. I'll leave the third chair for another time. Yeah, that'll do for now. We'll have a look at this one now. Dear old one. So, used to be my parents. So I reckon it's probably 60 years old. So we've lost a screw up here. When I say lost, it's actually broken. I've tried putting a new screw in there and it doesn't go in, so the old one's broken off in there. So I can either try and drill it out, or I can try and drill a hole right next to it and extend that area a bit and put a screw in just off centre. It's probably the easiest thing. These bolts we can tighten up. Under here, it's good old whatever you call that, a hole with a bit of wood in it. So I can just glue that, and same on that one, and push them back together. This feels a little bit loose. I'm guessing, because I can't actually move them, I'm guessing there may be a screw through there and the hole's been filled so you can't see it. And then at the back here, that's broken there. And that looks to me like it was probably just call it a hole and a dowel, I suppose. May have had a couple of nails in it as well, but I can't see them. And then here, these two, try not to hit the camera, that one, that screw is missing, that goes into there. That one is bent. I've tried unscrewing it, it moves a little bit, and then it doesn't move any further. So I'm not quite sure best option there either. Because I can't get it out. I've no doubt I could break it, but I think I might leave it, because although it's bent, it is holding it in place. So I can replace that one, glue that one. I might put a screw through from the outside to hold it in place. Glue that, glue that. Glue that. So that's 3 out of 4. Oh, I might as well glue that one as well. All 4 of them. Squeeze some glue in there. This is a lovely old chair. It's not an antique. Well, it nearly is nowadays, I suppose, but it's not from the 60s. And it's done really well. So, what I say, put some glue in those ones first. Push them up together. Squeeze some in there, that's a bit, can't get to it. Wedge it apart and get some glue in there. Ideally, you'd put the glue actually in the hole. Nanny's talking a bit loud, isn't she? I'm going to have to go and shut the door. Otherwise you'll all be listening to her and not paying attention to me. Have to drill that one. Thank you. Right, I can tighten these up. Okay. Screw them. Right. It hasn't gone in as far as I thought it had. That's better. Right. So I'm going to screw off at a bit of an angle and try and miss the existing screw hole, or the existing screw to be more exact. Okay, that went in. We need one for up there. I expect that'll be the same problem. Yeah, screw snapped off. Needs a bit of filler in it. Other than that, fixed. Although this needs a bit of something to hold it in place. I'll think about that. But apart from that, we're done. Oh, well, yeah, I've got to mix up some filler to fill that in, so it doesn't catch on the back of your clothes. Only thing left to fix on this chair now is how to fix the seat panel back in place. Now, I might use the method that was used before, which is a couple of bent nails. Four bent nails to be exact. Has to go through this little hole under there into the plywood here, and then into that hole there, so sort of an S shape. I was toying with the idea of making a proper metal bracket, so I'd have to cut a slot there for that to dig into and then screw it in place. But I think I might just use the bent nail technique. Bend a nail into a sort of S shape and nail it in place. Right, this is what I mean. A flat nail like this, I have to bend it. Well, that's no good. I've broken it. Might have to heat it then. Need to bend it into an S shape. So in that case, I'll go and heat it on the gas flame. See if we can bend it round into an S shape. Right, that's all we're talking about. So that bit's going to go through there, and then that bit I have to nail into the hole. So I'll just demonstrate in that hole. So it goes under there, so that holds it in place. Nail that in. So there's our hole. Hold it in place. It's not terribly strong, but there isn't, the force is the other way, so that way around it should be okay. Just see if we can demonstrate bending the nail. Nothing very clever, but you need to bend that end over sharp, and then the other end doesn't need to be quite so sharp. Got a cup of water there to put it in. As usual, it is noisy in here because we've got the dishwasher going as well. Let's warm that up. So that's what we want, a nice L shape there. Some slightly thinner pliers to hold it there. So I'm actually having to heat the end of the pliers just to get the heat into the nail.
Can you see that? I don't know if that's in focus or not. In the cold water. So there we go, a bent nail. So that's the nails in place. So it goes through the hole there and comes back that way. So out of the hole and into the wood that way. So S-shaped. Same over there, same there, and same there. My wife wants to take the cover off and wash it, but I'm not doing that. I know where it's going, and washing it won't be appreciated. The boys just want to sit on it. They don't want it. Well, it's going to get covered in food and that anyway. Right, there is one thing left to do. That is make up some filler of some sort to fill that hole, just so you don't get the sharp edges of the screw. You can see where they've been filled with proper wood putty, as it used to be called. I wouldn't know if it's still called the same thing now. I think what I'll do is I'll mix up some two-part epoxy and just fill the hole with it. I could use hot glue, but that'd be no good. Yeah. Two-part epoxy. What you would have done was you'd have mixed sawdust with glue to make a perfect match. But I'm not doing that either. Because I could fill it with baking powder and super glue. That's what I use a lot of the times now. Hadn't thought of that. So pour some super glue in there, sprinkle some baking powder in, and it goes off like concrete. Baking powder, super glue. Right, this is one where the top's glued. Oh no, managed to get it off. Is that gonna... No. Need to put a pin down there. Super glue's leaking over my hands at the moment, so I'm gonna have to deal with that. Back in a minute. Just brush the excess back into there. Powder. Yeah, I think that's done the job.
And that is rock hard. Yeah, that'll do. So as far as I'm concerned, that's job done.
Thanks for watching. You'll find more information down in the video description. You might like to watch that video up there, and you might like to subscribe over there.